Okay guys, in the last part of this tutorial we have seen how to import a data set and we have discussed some functions, some parameters like name, header, how to change header and how to create a new header and how to remove a header, and we have also discussed the parameter names, how to give in the name of our columns. Okay, so this is you can see in the column name ABCD. So I have discussed in the last video. Now we discuss some other functions or some other parameters. So how to import, as I have discussed in the last video, after importing this data, okay, and read this data. Now we have discussed some functions. The first we have discussed the head function. Head function tells about the first five row of our data set. Okay. So if we need to get the information of our first five row of our data set, then we call simple head function. So how to call this head function? Simple, we write df our data name, df1 our data frame name, df1 dot head, head head, and simply call this head function. Okay, and then simple run. Okay, you can see here first five row of our data set is here. Okay, if you pass in this parenthesis head number of row, suppose 10, 1 or 2, you can see that number of row are printed. Okay, suppose you need to first only one row, you want only the first row of our data set, then you pass only one and then simple run. As you can see here, our first row is printed here. Similarly, if you want to suppose the 10 row, first 10 row of our data set, then you pass here 10 and simple run. Okay, you can see here the first 10 row are printed, and this function is very useful to get the information about data set of any type of data. So with the help of head function, you fetch first n row, and first n row means as you pass n equal to any natural number, but it is important that here how many rows you want to fetch, it is necessary that row are included in our data set. Okay, now similarly, if you want to print the last five row, for this we have a tell function. Okay, so we call simple tell function with our data frame name. So df1 dot tell, as the name suggested, tell means the last value of our data. So by default it take five last value, and simply we pass here. So you can see here the last five value of our data set. As you can see our data set size is 150 row and 5 columns. So last 5 row means the 150th row and the 149, 148 and so on. Similarly, if you want to check the last row, only last 2 row or last 3 row, you can pass here. Suppose you can pass that number. Okay, suppose you need to pass only the last 2 rows, so you pass here 2 and simple run. So you can see here the last two row are printed. Okay, now we have seen how to handle missing value, okay, using Python. So first we write heading here with the help of the hash handle handling missing value. Okay, handling missing values and mark as a heading. Okay, then okay, and then run. So you can see here our heading is created, handling missing value. So for this, first we need to import our data here with the help of, because I have already imported the pandas library, as you can see in the previous video. Okay, as you can see the previous video, I have already imported the pandas library and load the data set in my C in my C drive. Okay, so in this data set now you can see that NaN value. So how to handle this type of NaN value? Or you can create, first we need to create other NaN value. Suppose for this first we need to go our data set. Okay, and suppose here we need to delete some values, like suppose we need to delete this and another value is this and one more this. Okay, and then save. Yes, okay, now go here and then again run our data set. Okay, very good. Now you can see we have our two other NaN value. It means a missing value, or NaN means numerical value. Okay, now we have seen how to handle this type of problem. Okay, if in our data set is our data set have a missing value, or in the place of missing value, suppose in our data set has hash n a or null value, then the pandas data frame consider is a null value. I mean this, if in our data set, this is my data set, suppose first here we write is hash n a n slash a, or here suppose write null. Okay, then save this file first. Yes, now we have seen our data set, our data, this our data set consider this hash NA or null value. What is the value in our data set in the pandas data frame? So first we need to run this. Okay, as you can see here, the hash NA or null value consider as a NAN in our data frame, or in our data set in pandas. So pandas can consider hash NA or null value as a NAN or missing value. Okay, now is challenging is to how to handle this type of data, because we need to clean our data. We need to remove this missing value or NAN value in our data set. Okay, if in our data set has other type of the missing value, suppose a garbage value, and we need to convert in NaN type value. So for this we have a special function called NA value, and then use this specific string. Suppose in our data set, this is my data set. In our data set here, suppose we delete this, and suppose here write not available, not available, or you write it, or we write in short not available. Okay, and suppose here write not avail. Okay, so this type of value consider in my data set is how to this type of value is considered is a NaN value. First we need to save this and then go our Jupyter notebook, and then again run this. Okay, now you can see in the new data set, you can see here the two value not avail, but we need to consider this not avail type of value as NaN. For this we write here simply separated by comma, write NA value. NA values equal to, and pass here not avail, not avail. Okay, and then again run. Okay, now you can see this type of not avail value consider here NaN type of value. Okay, so you can change this another type of garbage value in our data set into convert into NaN or not a numeric value type. Okay, so now Now, if our in our data set, suppose in the first in one place is right is not available, not available, and another in another place right, suppose another unnecessary data, suppose no value. So how to handle this type of problem? So this is my data type, this is my data sets, and suppose here right not value. Suppose here write not avail and another here write not avail. Okay, but suppose here we delete this and write no value. Okay, and here then write no value. Okay, now here write no value and here you can see here write not avail. So in this type of problem, how to handle? So for this to convert this type of problem NaN, we use the list. First we need to save this. And go to our in Jupyter notebook. Okay, now run again this. Okay, now you can see here. Now you can see here no value. Okay, no value. So for this we use for this for to handle this type of problem or convert this no value into the NaN, we use a list. So here we use list. Okay, and in the list we pass here first no not avail and then separated by comma pass another no unnecessary value. Suppose right here no value. Okay, no value and close the list and then run. Now you can see here the no value converted into NaN and the not avail value converted into NaN. So if you have another more than two or three or another type of non-necessary data in our data set, and how and first and we need to convert it into NaN. Okay, so we use list, we use the list and pass all type of value and then simply run. You can see all value converted in NaN. In the next video we will see how to handle this NaN type of missing type of value and how to remove and how to clean our data set. So all our operation in are include or in included in the cleaning of cleans cleaning or cleansing of data set. Okay, we use two words, cleaning of data and cleansing of data, both are same. Okay, so in the next video we will discuss how to handle this NaN value. I think it is clear all of you, and if you have any type of query and any type of related query, please write in comment section. And if you like this, please hit like button and subscribe the my channel. Thank you so much.